Hi, my name's Alison and I work at the Bath Visitor Information Centre, where we are at the moment in the heart of Bath. We're right in the centre of Bath here, next to the Abbey. Bath Abbey is another attraction as well, which we have. As I said, it went back to a Benedictine monastery, but then it was later rebuilt in the 12th century and in the 14th century. So it's a bit of a mixture of different eras. But it's got one of the best ceilings with fan vaulting in the whole of England, a bit like Westminster Abbey. These days you can go up in the tower as well, and you can see all over Bath from the top of the tower. Bath goes right back to Roman times. Our office is in front of the Roman baths, where the Romans were. The Roman baths are just here. The Romans came here when they found out that there was spa water, natural spa water, and it's here where they built the Roman baths. If you go to the Roman baths, you can't actually swim in the waters, but we've got a new construction which was built in 2006, funded with some Millennium money, and that's called Thermae Bath Spa, and people can actually go to Thermae Bath Spa to bathe in the water. Downstairs they've got a lovely swimming pool, and then upstairs they've got some steam rooms with lots of different aromas, and on the top floor they've got an open air swimming pool which looks over the whole of the city, and that's situated just a few blocks away from our office, just at the end of Bath Street. After the Romans left, we had the Georgians coming to Bath, so it's mainly a Georgian city. All of the Georgian part of the town is from here upwards. We've got some wonderful architecture in the city, up here around the circus. And also here, this is the Royal Crescent. This was built by John Wood the Younger and John Wood the Elder. They had studied Andrea Palladio in Italy in the 16th century. People like to go to number one Royal Crescent because it's a house which is in the Georgian style of the 18th century. Recently it's just amalgamated into the house next door, so you've got kitchen area, like an upstairs downstairs sort of thing, where you can go and visit an 18th century kitchen and an 18th century house and see how people would have lived during Georgian times. Over here, for instance, we've got the Fashion Museum, which is another of our interesting museums. This goes fashion that goes back about 400 years in time, but we've also got modern day fashion there. One of our finest museums is located at the end of Great Pulteney Street, which is also an 18th century street where we've had many films, and it's got lots of collectible things like porcelain, Gainsborough paintings as well. We've got one of the oldest houses in Bath, which dates back to the 14th century, which is called Sally Lunn's, which is now a refreshment house. It used to originally be a bakery, but they have these buns called Sally Lunn buns, which you can eat. They're a little bit like French brioche, and that's one of the oldest houses in Bath. We have a varied amount of restaurants in the city, so restaurants of different nationalities, plenty of Italian restaurants, Thai restaurants, Indian restaurants, all sorts of food you can get here in the city. Wine bars, also nightclubs around this area too. Thank you. although apart from the restaurants and the evening nightlife, we all have many things going on over the whole year, something like the Bath Literature Festival. In May we have our International Music Festival. We have a comedy festival. We've got a Jane Austen Festival in September that brings a lot of people in wearing lots of different 18th century costumes. A procession that goes around the city centre on a Saturday. Film festival, which is in November. And then our big, big festival of the year, which is run by Bath Tourism Plus, is the Christmas market, all in front of our office, over about 150 different chalets with all sorts of different Christmas things and souvenirs for people to buy.